Wow, 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 wow. Without you guys even knowing, it looks like a secret and massive buff on top of that took place for Jedi Master Luke Skywalker. I mean, holy cow, we're coming fresh off the Relic 9 video that we did a moment ago, which is why we got the Gucci goggles on and we're dressing in the Gucci from head to toe right now. And I do not have a Relic 9 Master Luke Skywalker yet. However, in that video, spoiler, put a card in the top right-hand corner. We talk all about everything you need to know with Relic 9. I said, in general, Master Luke Skywalker is going to be an amazing Relic 9. However, it looks like there may have been a secret buff, or maybe they broke something. Over at Capital Games, there was an update last night, and they did mention that how they fixed an issue with Master Luke Skywalker, in which he did not gain the visual effect for Master increases after his Master had been manipulated by Jedi Legacy. I don't know if that's related to this, or maybe this is something they forgot to mention in the notes, or it was a complete accident, but you need to know about it. This Galactic Legend just shot through the roof in terms of viability. We're going to show some before and afters here in a moment here, but Legend of the Jedi, one of the reasons why he was so great for Relic 9 upgrades is that he's going to allow your Jedi to do more damage with inherited teachings, because it's based off of 60% of Jedi Master Luke Skywalker's base max health. Now again, we only have Relic 8. It's funny how we say only nowadays with Relic 9 in the game. We do not have Relic 9, which would add a lot more protection to it. Do the math real quick. Before I show you before and afters, mathematically, what should be happening since it's 60% of our base max protection? If you're not rocking tons of protection, Master Luke, you are missing out on the whole point of inherited teachings here. So right now we have 115,476, and we're going to multiply that by 60. So every time we use inherited teachings, this is why I don't want to mess with my mods that much, because he does 69,000. Thousand damage when using inherited teachings. And let me show you the before footage, and we're going to hop into some gameplay in a moment with where it's now. It looks like they basically doubled it. It seems like my suspicion is they took his unique ability Galactic Legend and they practically turned all that max protection he gets with each relic upgrade into the conversation now. And he does pretty much double, almost nearly double the damage on inherited teachings. Bring him on over. So this is my stream the other day, our first time going up against Lord Vader. We're not going to run the whole battle. I want you to pay attention to how much damage we're going to do with inherited teachings. So Gary, let's roll some gameplay. So here we go. I believe we're going to call Jedi Knight Luke, and here we go. And we did 69,286 damage, which is basically what we did a moment ago. We'll do it a few more times. Again, it's true damage. It's not going to change no matter who you hit. So I think we go after Gary the Stormtrooper here for whatever reason. This is our first time going up against Master or Lord Vader. We don't really know the strategy. Not enough out there to really get a strategy. But nonetheless, we won. But here we go again. 69,286 damage. Hop on over to the game. Literally overnight with this update, either something broke or they forgot to mention, or they just figured, hey, let them test out their our game here. Let's just hop over to Cantina Battles. We'll hop over to Squad Arena to show you in a more practical sense what it looks like here. Master Luke Skywalker, again, my mods did not change from this video we're doing now to that stream. Same thing, but watch what happens now. We are way beyond doing 69,000 damage here. All right, here we go. We're going to one exit. And we're going to call in, just to keep it consistent, we're going to call in Jedi Knight Luke Skywalker, although it makes no difference who I call to the assist here. And 124,000 damage. Let's do Yoda this time. 124,000 damage. Practically doubling what we were doing before. It's called Gas Master. 124,000. Let's call in Jolie. 124,000! Holy cow, this guy should have been doing this when he first came out in 2021. I, my opinion would have greatly changed. 100,000 basically for free, especially in a day and age where they're nerfing the amount of damage you could possibly do nowadays, as we saw the great nerf of 2020. Okay, look, okay, you freaking shuff. You didn't need to delete the whole team. Massive amounts of damage going on right now. Let's hop in the Squad Arena. And the way I figured this out, I was just practicing around with my counters for in Grand Arena, basically practicing against my Master Kenobi, always staying on the tippity edge when it comes to off-meta counters. It's really weird to see Master Luke Skywalker being considered an off-meta counter. But here we go. Let's hop into a practical setting. And how about we go ahead and we throw in our typical team on how this operates right now. We're going to hop in, and this is our normal lineup for beating these teams. We bring in Yoda, Jedi Knight Luke Skywalker, Jedi Knight Revan, and Jolie. And when I'm practically doing double the damage, that's going to help a ton against these teams. Massive amounts of protection health, like Master Kenobi, as well as the Lord Vader team. So, all right, we're going to let them do their thing here. We're going to go ahead and first, we have to play it the right way. We got to make sure we increase cooldowns here. There we go. Increase the cooldowns for a moment. Taking that, it doesn't really matter all that much. Now we're going to mark her down. We'll get to the inherited teach in a moment. Let's make sure we set ourselves up for the right strategy. We've made videos on this in the past, in case you're curious. Let's do that real quick. Spread around some foresight. And now we'll start getting some work done. There we go. That's why we needed that, to make sure we didn't get wrecked by that attack right there. Okay, so let's start getting some stuff done. Let's get that foresight back on Yoda, 124,000 damage. I give it to Luke. We should do 100. Like, holy cow, we're plowing through this Commander Tano a lot faster than before. We're going to hold off on this right now. I actually think we misplayed. I think we're supposed to actually swap the Luke instead. A little misplay at the beginning, but we're a little too excited right now about this secret buff that happened. All right, let him do the high ground. We didn't use the stun because they were going to cleanse it off anyways, most likely. We'll throw up a stun in a moment here. Just do a basic for right now on Commander Tano. And let's not do that. Let's just go ahead and do basic. And she should be gone in 3, 2, and 1. Holy cow. The damage is getting pretty bonkers on this Jedi Master Luke Skywalker. We're surpassing that 69,000 damage threshold we had. Let's just go ahead and do that. So now it got reduced a little bit. Ignore that for a moment. That's mostly, I believe, Master Kenobi's high ground going to full effect right now. But once he gets out of high ground, we're going to get back to that 124,000. Even so, the 99,000 damage you're doing right now, that far surpasses where we were before. All right, this is going to hurt just a little bit. Sorry, Luke. I know. Well, you'll get that Relic 9 one day, I'm sure. Drop that stun. Slow him down a little bit here. All right, let's go ahead and mark down General Anakin Skywalker. Going all in on him. And let's start smashing these big hits right here. And let's start doing some more inherited teachings here. So let's go ahead and give it to Luke. There we go. 99,000 damage. Way past that big threshold of 69,000 before. Chopping the ultimate. Doing a little Viagra Luke here. Let's go mark down General Anakin Skywalker. Get him out of the picture. This battle just got so much easier. And let's just keep, I don't know, spread all those buffs around. Yeah, there we go. Beautiful dodge right there. We're going to go after Commander Tano. Actually, drop a stun. I know. All right, now we'll go back to this. And there we go. 124,000. Back to it now that Kenobi's out of that ultimate stance right there. Just do this again. There, holy cow. Again, it's unclear right now. I don't have direct access to the developer, so I can't even ask if I wanted to. Unclear right now if this is intended or not. But wow, I'm even getting reports right now. As we're streaming right now, big shout out to Chimi Nai, who also came across this. They said that they actually lost to a Jedi Master Luke Skywalker team. With this damage practically doubling, this team just got absolutely bananas. Let's go ahead and pass it over there just for the funsies of it. Yes, keep doing this. Let's do this. I love the Jedi over there. That's not what the ability is called, but that's what I like to call it. Let's go ahead, increase cooldowns, drop it over there. We'll bring Jedi Revan back. This bad, normally you have to have a little bit of a heart attack going up against this team. Doesn't seem to be the case anymore here. Here we go. Bring him on back. Drop it over there. Let's go ahead. We're going to give it over to Revan. Massive, crazy. All right, let's wrap this up. Enough screwing around. Whew. Holy cow. Look at the damage that's going on right now. Give it to Luke, and let's even get one more inherited teaching before we wrap this up here. Here we go. Just to show you guys. Give it to Luke. Wow. This guy is a monster now. I mean, this is the love story that you want to see. The Romeo and Juliet of Galaxers. He was my most hated Galactic Legend this year. And I appreciate it more because of his viability against Master Kenobi, as well as Lord Vader. But with this, if this is indeed going to stick around and it was intended, this Galactic Legend is easily number two in my book. If this is actually how he's supposed to operate in the game. I mean, wow. So there you go. Everything you need to know with the secret buff that happened. I'll keep you guys up to date if this was an accident or if this was indeed intentional. But the reason why I'm putting this out there is because if you're wanting that Galactic Legend, Master Luke is one a lot of people have because the requirements are kind of, you know, they build on top of each other kind of nice. And you have some good characters along with it. Popular Galactic Legend shot up in massive viability with literally doubling the damage and doing 124,000 damage plus. And I probably could do even more if I change my mods around a little bit. And that's not even including Relic 9. into the picture. We probably could do like 140, 50,000 damage per, maybe more like 130,000 with the Relic 9 upgrade. So, wow! Holy cow, busy day in Star Wars Galaxy's Light. Comment down below, is this something you noticed too? And if not, well, let me just tell you, your squadron climbs are going to get a lot easier against those Kenobis that are lurking around out there. And heck, even makes the Lord Vader battles even easier. So like, comment down below, and subscribe so you're not missing a thing. And always remember, holy cow, game is in a weird spot right now, and it's getting incredibly whaley, but at least here in the Kyber Club on Not an Alderaan, let me just tell you, it's great to be in the Empire today.